In this learning module, we will examine the basic features of Spotfire visualizations. It may be helpful to consider these general features, which are common across visualization types, before focusing on specific Spotfire visualizations. Because visualizations represent the heart of the Spotfire analysis environment, the ability to adjust the properties of visualizations is an essential skill for you to master. Spotfire visualizations are the primary mechanism for displaying data in underlying data tables. And, although there are a variety of visualization types, there are some common settings which apply to most or all visualizations. For example, each visualization has a properties dialog, and may have additional settings dialogs depending upon the visualization type. These dialogs control a vast array of features and options presented by the visualization, including the application of color, the separation of a visualization into separate trellis panels, and the addition of reference lines or curve fitting to the plot. Columns from the underlying data table are the primary selectable unit for visualization properties, and some of their features, like the default number formatting or sort order of values, can be controlled in the Column Properties dialog. Speaking of default options, the very nature of Spotfire visualizations is to begin with default settings and make adjustments in order to achieve the view that suits your needs. Control over many of these default settings occurs in the Options dialog. Finally, before we examine these dialogues in a demonstration, it should be noted that visualizations are organized onto pages, and organizing the page layout is another essential skill required for working within the Spotfire analysis environment. Pay attention as some tips for how to configure a page layout are related in the demonstration which follows. We will begin our demonstration in an empty analysis session's welcome screen, where, from the Add section, we can select Open File. We will navigate to the Excel file with SS Megamart in the title and click Open. When presented with the Excel import dialog, we can click OK and the default visualization type is displayed, in this case a table visualization. If your default visualization is not a table, you can right-click, select Switch Visualization to Table. The table visualization gives us a quick view of the underlying data table, and, in conjunction with the filters created for each column in that table, may represent all that we wish to include on this page. Let's rename the page Data Table, so that we might return to this tab whenever we want to examine the data provided for this Megamart chain of department stores. Now, we'll insert a new page, either by accessing this option from the main menu, or clicking on this icon in the toolbar. The filters and details on demand panels are added to the page, but the remainder of the space is available for visualizations. We could use the Insert menu to select from this list of new visualization options, or we could use the corresponding icons on the toolbar menu. Let's insert a scatter plot onto this page. You can see that the visualization is already configured with default settings. Electronics has been selected for the X-axis values, furniture has been selected for the Y-axis values, and store location has been chosen as the color by variable. Each of those properties is controlled by a selector, which we can use to change the column selected for the x-axis values to clothing. We could use the y-axis selector in the same manner to represent shoe purchase amounts along this axis. The selector which controls color can be adjusted in the legend. Let's choose gender as the color by variable, and you can see that other selectors are presented in the legend, and the none label indicates that no variable has been applied to that visualization property. For example, the shapes of all markers are currently the same. However, if we use this selector to choose store setting, the three values in the store settings column, as indicated by the filter which corresponds to that column, define the three unique shapes seen in the markers in this plot. Another option for adjusting visualization properties uses the filters as a column selector. For example, let's say that we wanted to change the x-axis values from clothing to garden purchase amounts. We could locate the garden filter, then drag it on top of the visualization until a series of targets is displayed. If we drop this column upon the x-axis target, it will be applied to that visualization property. Another visualization property which is easy to control with a drag and drop is the trellis property. If we locate the store location filter and drag and drop it on the final target, it will split the visualization into separate trellis panels, one for each store location. While selectors and drag and drop are convenient ways to adjust visualization properties, there is also a dialog which is accessed using this gear-shaped icon called the Properties Dialog, available on all visualization types. This dialog is the most comprehensive location for making adjustments to the properties of a visualization. And while this learning module doesn't afford the time to go into great detail about all of the features which can be controlled from within each section of this dialog, we should touch upon at least a few. In the Lines and Curves section, we could check this box in order to add a vertical reference line and click the Edit button in order to adjust the position of that line to a fixed value of 200. When we click OK, you can see the position of that reference line on the visualization. Consequently, it might be useful to slide this dialog to the side and resize slightly in order to be able to immediately evaluate the impact of the changes we make within this dialog. Let's go to the Labels section and use the now familiar Property Selector to choose the values in the Customer ID column to display as labels. By default, the labels are set to show for only marked rows. We could change this to all, but the result would be a visualization which is overly crowded with labels. So let's return this to marked rows, such that the labels will be displayed only when one interacts to mark data in the visualization. Note that the x-axis, y-axis, color, and trellis properties we previously adjusted using selectors or a drag and drop approach are also available for adjustment within the properties dialog. But here, there are a more extensive set of control options. For example, in the x-axis section, we could elect to display markers along a log scale and show grid lines. Note that when we are done with this dialog, there is no OK or Apply button, so we can simply click Close. Before creating another visualization, let's click where there are no markers in order to clear the marked data. Then, click on the bar chart icon from the toolbar menu in order to insert that visualization type onto this page. Again, default settings have been applied to this visualization, and it is our job to evaluate those settings and make adjustments such that the visualization suits our immediate needs. The category axis of this bar chart has been set to display a bar for each store location, while the value axis indicates that the height of each bar reflects the count of rows. In this example, that is equal to a count of customers who shop in each store location, which appears to be somewhere between 150 and 200 customers per store. Let's use this selector to change the bar height to represent the values in the garden column. While this selector remains displayed, we could grab here to slide it aside in order to appreciate the range of the value axis and note that the roughly 150 to 200 values from the underlying data table, which represent each bar, have been added together to generate a sum of those values, displayed as the height of each bar. This drop-down list allows you to select a different aggregation method, like an average, and the bar height will adjust accordingly. Let's return the aggregation to sum, then note that the selector is currently being viewed in collapsed mode. If we use this icon to toggle into expanded mode, additional adjustment options are displayed, such as the ability to change the display name for this selector. We'll enter something more meaningful, like total garden purchases, and close the selector dialog. Currently, there is only a single column applied to the category axis of this visualization. However, there is a plus selector presented which allows you to add a second column, like store setting, in order to further subdivide the bars based upon those three values within each store location. Let's insert one more visualization on this page, a pie chart visualization. In this visualization type, the only selectors made immediately available are presented within the legend. So we could elect to color by store setting and change the sector size to count the number of customers in each store setting. Because we do not want to confuse the colors assigned to each gender with the colors assigned to each pie sector, we might click upon the rural color in the legend key and change it to orange. Then do the same to change the color applied to the relative count of suburban customers, our largest demographic. Note that we are left-clicking on these key color elements in order to present the color palette. A different set of controls is presented if we right-click. This menu controls the elements which are displayed in the legend. For example, we could right-click on the legend of the bar chart in order to hide the color by selector from this legend. Be cautious, though, because the menu you are presented upon right-click will vary dependent upon exactly where you are right-clicking. For example, right-clicking in the center of the visualization will present a different menu than right-clicking on axis labels. These right-click menus are just another shortcut to adjusting visualization properties, as you can see when we use the right-click menu to change the x-axis of the scatter plot back to a linear scale by unchecking the log scale option. Currently, the layout of these three visualizations on the page is less than ideal. We can reposition the pie chart to appear next to the bar chart by grabbing the title bar and dragging until a ghost image appears over one side of the bar chart. We can also resize by clicking and dragging any of the borders between visualizations. As you can see, legends take up quite a bit of space in the visualization area. The invisible line separating the legend from the elements of the visualization will allow you to resize the legend. Or you could use the icon located in the visualization title bar to hide the legend altogether. A hidden legend can be exposed again, temporarily, in popover mode by clicking on the icon. If you want to redock the legend to the visualization, click on the pin icon. Note that closing the panels on the page will also afford extra space for visualizations, and those panels can be retrieved using these toolbar icons. Think carefully, though, before clicking here to close a visualization. The result of closing this scatter plot is, in actuality, the act of deleting that scatter plot, and along with it, all of the hard work we did configuring the properties of that visualization. If we insert a new scatter plot, we're back to square one. Therefore, let's click the undo button a number of times until our mistakenly deleted scatter plot returns to the page. We have discussed all of the menu items displayed along the visualization's title bar, except one. This triangle drop-down menu presents one more shortcut to select controls, which could otherwise be adjusted by launching the Comprehensive Visualization Properties dialog. For example, adding a zoom slider to the x-axis of this visualization in order to be able to focus in on the high density of customers making lower garden purchase amounts. There are two more dialogues we should touch upon, as they will indirectly impact our visualizations. Under the Edit menu, the Column Properties option will launch a dialog which, among other things, will allow you to format numbers. Let's select the Garden Department and format the number to display 0 digits past the decimal and use a thousand separator. We could also change the sort order for values in categorical data columns. Let's select Store Location and click on the Sort Order tab in order to configure a custom sort order. By default, the values are sorted alphabetically. We could use the buttons along the side to present East Coast locations before West Coast locations. When we click OK and click OK, the sort order of the store location values in the bar chart and the trellis panels in the scatter plot have both adjusted to present East Coast locations first, then West Coast locations. In addition, the number formatting has been applied to the value axis of the bar chart and the x-axis of the scatter plot. Note, though, that we still have the option to adjust number formatting independently for each visualization. For example, we could visit the Properties dialog for the bar chart, go to the Formatting section, and change the value axis numbers to use the short number format before closing the Properties dialog. You can see that the bar chart now substitutes a K in the thousands place, while the scatter plot still uses the number format we selected in the Column Properties dialog. Okay, we have one more important dialog to discuss. Under the Tools menu, we can select Options in order to launch a dialog which allows you to adjust your default behavior of the application. For example, as we examine the visualization section of this dialog, you can see the default fixed color which was applied to the bars in the bar chart. Let's change that to orange. And in the bar chart section, let's switch the default orientation from vertical to horizontal bars. When we click OK, don't be surprised when nothing happens to existing visualizations. The changes we made in the Tools Options dialog impact the default settings applied to new visualizations only. Therefore, if we add a new page and insert a bar chart visualization, the bars are horizontally oriented and colored orange by default. As we return to the Options dialog, please be aware that any changes which are made here impact the default settings at the level of the application, not this specific analysis document. Therefore, the next time we open new data and insert a bar chart, the bars will be horizontal and orange. As we conclude our discussion of basic visualization features, let's review the different ways we have learned to adjust visualization properties. Property selectors can be found aligned with visualization axes and in the legend, as well as throughout the various sections of the properties dialog. Don't forget about the ability to expand these selector dialogs in order to interact with additional settings options. Filters can be used to drag and drop onto visualization targets in order to quickly assign columns to visualization properties. Right mouse clicking results in different control menus depending upon where you click. In addition to right clicking to expose shortcut control menus, the triangle drop-down menu on the title bar provides quick access to a select set of visualization properties. However, the properties dialog is the most comprehensive way to make adjustments to a visualization. This extremely valuable dialog can be accessed anywhere the gear-like icon appears, or via the right-click menu, which results when clicking in most areas of a visualization.